Hello, I'm Eric Renault, and this is a video for tipsquirrel.com, the free website for everything Photoshop. In this video, I'll be taking a look at a brand new feature of Adobe Camera Raw. So let's jump in and see what's what. So here we are. You can see I've already loaded my image into Adobe Camera Raw, and I've made a few adjustments. Now, I took this image down at the Gatwick Aviation Museum, where I was helping out a friend of mine, Gavin Hoey, at one of his workshops. Now, I've got a little bit of a problem with this in that I like this image, but I don't like the sky. It's just not got enough drama in it for me. So I'm going to remedy that. Now, the first thing I'm going to do is add a tiny little bit of a vignette on it. So I'm going to go to the effects panel here, and then I'm going to bring down the amount to about minus 15-ish. There we go, 15. And the midpoint I'm going to take up to about 70-ish. And that just darkens the edges just a little bit. Let's bring this roundness up. There we go. Just to take that vignette out a little bit. I'm a bit happier with that. I'm going to click over here just to bring us back to our normal panel. There we go. What I'd like to do now is add a gradiated filter. So what I'm going to do here is just click and drag it down. And there we go. That's looking a bit better. Let's bring the exposure right down so we can see where it's taken an effect. I can actually bring that down a little bit further and maybe bring that down a little bit. There we go. Now, the problem I have, and it's not going to stay like this, but the problem I have is that the graduated filter goes over the pilot, and that's not what I want at all. Now, this could be a landscape, for example, and there could be a nice building in the way. So let's remedy that. First of all, I'm going to turn off the overlay. You don't have to, but I'm going to here just so I can see where I'm working. And what's new in Adobe Camera Raw, and at the time of recording isn't available in Lightroom, is this up here, the brush. So if I click on that, we can now use a brush to add or take away from the filter. So I'm going to click on minus, then bring my cursor on, and you can see that I've got a circle. And this is the brush. I can make this bigger and smaller using the square brackets, right and left. And I can change the feathering of it using shift left and right brackets. Now the flow, I can just come over here and click down as well. I'm going to leave that around about 50. It works pretty well. Now you'll notice I've got auto mask switched off. I don't use auto mask in Adobe Camera Raw or Lightroom. I don't find it works terribly well. I'm going to make this a bit smaller. I'm going to make it a little bit harder. And now I can just come in and minus away from where I want the graduated filter. There we go. And the pilot there is all done. Now I would like to take a little bit more time on this, maybe zoom in a little bit and get right up to the edges, but I don't want to bore you too much. Now let's do this other part of the cockpit. So again, I'm going to come across, I'm going to come into there and go across like so. Now if I go over the edges, just like that, which is easily done, of course, you may think that I can come in and plus it back in. Now, up here, you'd be absolutely right, because that's where 100% of this filter was working. Let's make that a bit smaller. There we go. And I can just plus this back in. However, if I come down, you'll notice that I get it 100%, even where the graduated filter wasn't taking any kind of effect in the first place. I'm going to Control or Command Z that a few times. I'm going to work on this a little bit more carefully. There we go. I'm just going to come across here. Whoop, I'm on, still on plus. Let's go on minus. Nice big brush there. And just come along. And on this image, I don't really need to go right up to the edges because they're quite dark anyway. And I'm going to bring down the graduated filter. Let's come across here and take this out as well. There we go. I've just noticed there's a bit too much on the pilot than I really, really wanted. Again, that's something I can sort out at a later date. I'm going to bring up the exposure back up all the way. Let's go to somewhere around about minus 85-ish. There we are. That's all I really wanted for this. I wanted to bring down the highlights just a little bit. There we go. Now I'm going to add clarity. Of course, it was a Gavin Hoey workshop, so you have to add clarity. And then a bit of saturation as well. Just bring the blues out in the sky. There we go. Now that's a lot more dramatic and works really well, and that's all thanks to the graduated filter. I'm Eric Renault. Thank you very much for joining me here And don't forget to subscribe and join us all at tipsquirrel.com. Bye-bye for now.